Hey guys, I'm LB, and we are back playing Rebirth, the community map for the Talos Principle by Moose Moose. And Moose Moose told me that we did jumping the fence wrong, and I already knew that. I already knew that I'd exploited something I wasn't supposed to do by jumping from there over the fence there. So I've been messing around with this for like an hour now, and I think I finally figured something out. And we're gonna test it real quick. I am determined to solve this the correct way. I feel like I'm so close. So if we jam this from here, then... Oops, come on. We can take the jammer inside, right? And jam this from here. And you might think this is completely pointless to do this, but you'll notice... We can actually jam this fizzler... this barrier from here. Can't jam fizzlers in this game. Like, this is a fizzler and you can't jam these. So once we've done that, right? I'm gonna go back into here, and then I wanna move this. I don't know, here? I'm trying to remember how I did this. No, because we wanna be able to get back out, so we'll put this here, right? I'm actually coming up with this live. I figured out this little trick here, and then I decided to start recording. So let's see. Done that, right? So now I want to do this. How does that help me, though? What actually happens when we're... Does this... Should be over the barrier? What?! Oh! Well, that's useful to know! Well, now I know what to do! That's actually the solution right there! Okay, that is definitely what it means by jumping the fence. This is the fence that we're jumping! Jeez, how did I not figure that out sooner? I can't believe I never tried that! Well, now we know what to do! That is the solution, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so now... we do is we just take this up here, right? Oops, come on. Then we come in here, and we can just take the jammer with us, in fact. And yeah, look at that. Ta-da! Wow, that was extremely simple. Why didn't I do that a long time ago? Wow. Alright, well we're done. That's the puzzle. That's the intended solution. And this is where the sigil would be, but I already collected it with my cheaty methods. We did it! That is actually really cool. I like that. But I also can't believe it took me so long to figure that out. Alright, let's get out of here. We're gonna move on to greener pastures. I actually don't know what to do for the rest of this episode. We have a lot of puzzles we need to do, and I'm not sure which ones I wanna try. Let's try this mega puzzle over here. Because I think I've tried it twice with a headache, and decided against it. So we might as well spend, you know, the other 17 minutes of this episode here. One flew. Alright, so we can head over here. All these windows, how did I not notice them before? Of course, I don't think that helps at all, really. See, this double barrier thing, this confuses me. Oh yeah, inside of greater purpose, I got a hint. I can't remember who gave me the hint, but somebody gave me a hint. I think it might have been Moose Moose. Or somebody, I don't know. Or maybe it was Portal Master? Also, by the way, in one of my episodes I said prototype instead of Portal Master. Somebody said to think about the purpose of the jammer. And I guess we're gonna have to figure that out some other day, because I wanna go do this puzzle that we were just a moment ago that I left for no reason. Think about the purpose of the jammer. Alright, we'll let that simmer in the back of my mind while we do this. So... we can get in here. I think I had the jammer here at one point. Or something. Then we have this double barrier here. This is specifically designed to prevent using the jammer here. As we've learned in greater purpose. Alright, well there's not much we can do here right now. I don't remember how to start the puzzle, really. We can go into here. and get the box. Yeah, okay. Huh. Do we want the box in or out? I think we, for the initially starting, we want it here, right? So we have the broken connector, and we have the other connectors connected to each other, with the broken connector blocking the beam to show us that that's a thing, but... why? It could just be decorative, I don't know. Hang on, let me... I just remembered, I might... if this video quality looks absolutely terrible, I have to apologize because... I may have forgotten to change it back after my Duskers livestream. Because for Duskers, for livestreaming to YouTube, I have to have it at 7500 kilobytes. And then for recording Talos, I have to have it at 10,000 kilobytes. Otherwise the quality looks bad. So if the quality of this episode isn't very good, I apologize. I will fix it next episode. Wanted to do this first, right? And then... right, we wanted to figure out... do we want to do that? Oh yeah, there's another connector in there I forgot about. No, because this won't... that won't even reach. Yeah, that's... okay. So if we just do this to start off with, right? Eventually use this to block this? Looks like it's not high enough, or I'm not putting it in the right spot. Oh, it blocked it for a split second, but yeah, it's not high enough. Alright, so then we take this off. That does that, right? So now we can go over here. Question is, do we want to take stuff in or out? Yeah, that does that. That's not really too useful to us right now. That's the problem. At the end of the day, we just want the jammer here. And then, we want a blue laser as well. How are we gonna pull that off? And how do we want to use the broken connector? The thing that scares me the most about this puzzle is the broken connector. Because every puzzle with a broken connector has involved tricky laser stuff, and while it's been cool, it has also been very tricky. Yep, I can't run there in time. That delay is not slow enough. If we set that up, will they alternate or will I just not? Will it not work the way I want it to? Alright, so we'll use this one to extend the length. That way, they should be even. Oh, that happens way too quick. Yeah, that is way too quick. What I really want to have happen is it just interrupt the beam. I wonder if the... Because if it intercepts the beam without going through one of the connectors, there's a grace period that we learned about in, George of the Jungle. This was just where the jammer was. Okay. Let's do... that. Oh, nope, that's not what I wanted to do. So there's that, right? At one point, I actually had this other thing open here. Oh yeah, because I just need the red. The thing is, there's no way to open this barrier without the jammer, so since we only have one jammer, there's no way to do anything there. This area is still perplexing to me. I guess we will eventually find a way to get in here, someday. And that's just, I guess, anti-trapping. Can't really think of a use for it right now. Too fast to do anything useful with this, I assume. We could get this permanently open, right? Let's try that. That might be a direction to go in. Oops, come on. Oh, what am I doing? I need to put the other connector in position first. This might make magic happen. Okay, we've done that, now what? Yeah, let me actually try taking this in here, right? Barrier. Interesting. Oh, what happened there? What? Oh. Well, that's a thing. Question is that a thing I want? Think so. Oh, what am I doing? I am making this way harder than it needs to be. There, permanently open. Except I crossed the beams like an idiot. Oh, wow. Let's try this again. Oh, what? You can take the box and put it back quickly enough? Wow, that's actually a thing. I don't think... Would they have programmed that intentionally, you think? Or would it just be, like, a happy accident? Not Moose Moose, but I mean Protein. There we go, now that is what I call permanently open. As long as I don't move that connector. And as long as I didn't need to connect it to that somehow. In fact, I probably did. Well, it's not too late. I can just do that right now. Yeah, that works. So, what are we gonna do about this? Again, I'm worried about the broken connector. Huh. I'll stick these out and set it up the normal way, I suppose. I am still deathly afraid of that broken connector. Okay, so the lasers don't cross, that's a good sign. Somehow, I need to interfere... Oh! Why didn't I do that before? I think I might know what to do. Maybe. Sort of. Oops, come on, let me through. So we go here, right? We put this jammer on this side. And then we take... take this with us, right? We connect it there. So it goes over the fence, and we want it to collide... here-ish? Might have to just angle it. Okay... How do I get these beams to cross? Basically, I just want the beams to intersect. I have no idea what to do with that broken connector. Let's go look at this from another angle, shall we? Oh, come on, I missed. Yeah, because once we shut that off, it should stay off permanently. It just needs to be a temporary shut-off. What would we use the broken connector for, though? It's not like a... Yeah, I don't see a pressure plate over here, I just... I feel like this puzzle's still gonna be a bit more complicated once we actually have the jammer on this side, right? What exactly is the point of opening this? Maybe I don't need to do that yet. Maybe I don't even need it open yet. Maybe I can get the beams across there-ish. I don't know, let's try. Alright, so we go here, place the jammer on this side. Take the working connector. Hey, there we go. That's what I wanted. We've done that now, right? This has to be opened by the jammer. And now we need blue in here. Okay, I think I know what I'm doing. We do that, now we can take this guy. Actually, we just want this for now. Do that. Wait a sec. Why am I overcomplicating things? I feel like I'm overcomplicating things. I think we might just be done already. Yeah, I think we're just done already. Yep. Looks like it. Alright, I made that way harder than it needed to be. Well guys, as always, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. You can show your appreciation with one of the two buttons below the video. And I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye.